Welcome back to the Glen Alex Show, where it's all about health. We talk about topics that are not publicly discussed in relation to total health. Diet and exercise are important, but they are not the only aspects of being healthy. So Nicole and I discussed resolutions in the first segment. Now we are moving on. We're going to go a little deeper into that. I decided a few years ago to really not do resolutions because I try to live day to day. I try to be the best person I can be from day to day, moment to moment, and not have this artificial idea of who I should be at a given time. With that, however, okay. Just this week, I've had three situations where there were boundary issues. Had specific agreements with three different individuals, personally and in business, and there have been violations. We've had very clear, specific agreements. Some were in writing, some were verbal, and they've all been violated in this short period of time. So that is a call to me. You asked me earlier, what am I attracting? So I need to take a look at what is going on in my world that is allowing this to happen or drawing it to me. So firming up my boundaries, it will be on my radar for this year.
Okay, so now for people listening, you know, you seem to be a very assertive person. I know you to be a very assertive person. And in fact, one of the things that I've complimented you on before is being very clear in setting boundaries and communicating with people in a way that maintained your composure and maintained your reputation, your dignity, all of that. I've been super impressed with that. So I'm surprised that you have that issue. And I did ask, I'm like, what areas do you have an issue stress in? Personal, family, business? And you said,
all
yes.
And
I'm like, okay, then that's you. There's something happening
with you.
Yeah,
there's something here.
Because I think most people listening would say that, okay, she's articulate and an assertive, positive personality. So speaking verbally, there probably isn't a lot of gray area. And you just said one of the boundaries that was written was in writing. So it's kind of, I tend to usually give people the benefit of the doubt when they roll over with me with their truck the first time. I'm like,
yes,
no, it's okay.
Yes,
I know it was
yes.
an accident. You've got insurance. It's fine. When they back that truck up and roll over me again, I'm like, okay, that was intentional. Done.
Yes.
So how do you set a boundary when you have, for example, set a boundary in writing?
Well, the first thing is, it's after setting the boundary, then you have to reinforce the boundary. You can reinforce the boundary verbally with follow-up, or you can do it tangibly.
Okay.
So if someone is calling you late at night, you've asked them not to do that, you pick up the phone and say, I'm on my way to bed, don't call me, then the next step for me would to be, don't answer the phone.
Gotcha.
And then the step after that would be to block their number.
Gotcha.
If they continue to disrespect my request. In these cases, I'm pretty assertive. I'm pretty clear. Yet some people still think there's a loophole where they can make unilateral decisions that affect my resources, financial, time and energy.
Gotcha.
And be okay with that. And when I'm not, so I can be pretty firm. I had a sister describe my anger as venom. So I'm working on I know I needed to work on the balance between holding people accountable.
Right.
And not being a bitch about it.
Right, right. Or maybe closing off, repairing or leaving some room for maybe them to repair.
Yes.
An error.
Yes.
Maybe opening up a dialogue or a conversation to find out what your part was in it. You know, what gave you the impression that what we had written in this agreement would be okay to now do B instead of A.
Yes.
So maybe being open to see what your part was in it. You know, because sometimes it's really easy where I'm like, okay, I told you not to call. I picked up the phone. I said, don't call, but you pick up the phone. And then
right.
you stop picking up the phone. Sometimes it's not that cut and dry. So, I would think that it would probably be it. For me, when I see someone does something wrong to me, what I consider wrong,
mm-hmm.
I usually tend to internalize and think, okay, now how could I have done that better? Sometimes that's gotten me in trouble in the past, and
okay.
you know that.
Yes.
That I've, you know, let me fix you. I'm super
yes.
smart. I'm
yes.
brilliant. I can
yes.
make this work.
Well, there's a difference between giving people the benefit of the doubt and letting them off the hook.
Okay.
I am very purposeful about not letting people off the hook. This is what we agreed to. These are the consequences. And if anything changes for you, then let's have a conversation about that. The difference between having a conversation and making adjustments in the agreement and then walking off, making it a decision for me, that's the issue that I have. So that is something that I need to look at. And you're right, there's something that I'm attracting because it's happened in such a short period of time in different areas of my life. What I think is important for the audience to get from this, though, is that in your New Year's resolutions, in any goals you have in life about fitness or education or career, then boundaries are going to be critical in you being able to do that. Because when you introduce something new into your circle, your family, your work relationships, there will be some pushback because people are uncomfortable with change and they will impose that discomfort on you. So even family, even spouses, they will under the radar work to keep you the same because that's where their comfort zone is.
Yeah.
So with appropriate boundaries and reinforcement of those boundaries, then you can have a healthier, happier life. It's not going to be easy. Don't get me wrong. You know, saying no is not the easiest thing all the time, or even sometimes. However, it is the necessary thing if you want to take that next step and be the healthiest you can be in the different areas.
Yeah.
So I have some work to do. I know that.
All right. So are you expecting like a moment of epiphany where you'll be like, oh, this is what I did, or this is where I need to make an adjustment? How does that process work for you? Is every person able to self-assess them, or do you need to sometimes maybe go to a friend or a coach or a counselor? When do you seek a professional?
First, I will say, what could I have done differently? I try to take responsibility for my part in any interaction, issue, problem, whatever, just as you alluded to earlier. If I'm not getting any clarity with that, then I will do a reality check. I will send a text or call a friend, someone I trust, my longtime mentor, and say, hey, am I seeing this clearly? How do you see this? Give me some feedback. So we do need objective reality checks. So you have to make sure that the people around you have your best interest at heart and are less interested in keeping you where they are comfortable. So yes, first the self-assessment, and then second, reaching out. And then if it becomes an issue of severe depression or anxiety, if you're getting debilitated and you can't function day to day, then you definitely need to reach out to your primary care provider first or seek mental health services, which is not about being crazy. Okay,
right.
Seeing a counselor or a therapist is about learning coping skills. Okay. Yeah. Did you know how to drive when you first got in a car? No, you have to learn step by step what to do. It's the same thing with mental and emotional issues.
Yeah.
We need help sometimes.
Yeah, and you're right. And I think sometimes you do need to go to a professional beyond your circle of your mentors or your families or your friends. I have a family member that is struggling with depression, and she came to me, and I listened and I heard and I loved and all of that. And I recommended that she needs to move on to either, you know, a psychologist or maybe a psychiatrist. And she was absolutely opposed to that. And I kind of gave her the example. I'm like, look, you can come to me all day long and talk about how frustrated you are that your teeth are crooked. And I can relate. I can maybe give you some tooth floss and give you some pretty lipstick to keep from people from looking at your teeth. Are you feeling better about your mouth? But ultimately, if she wants her teeth fixed,
she has to see a professional.
She's got to go to an orthodontist. I'm not an orthodontist, as much as I can commiserate and listen. And I think that that's something that a lot of us can get into, that we band-aid our problems with our friends, maybe with drinking, maybe with food, maybe with, you know, shutting ourselves off to the world. And that's when those other areas of health affect your total and your overall health.
Yes.
So
absolutely. Just don't be afraid to reach out, because the help is there. And in the therapeutic process, you have a safety net. You can say things in the therapeutic session that you would not dare to say to anyone else. You can make disclosures, you can make confessions, you can say things that will help you relieve the stress, the pressure, the tension, the frustration, the anger, the depression in a way that you can't get with a familiar person.
I love it. Great topic, Glen. Once again.
Thank you.